Here again, we do have our remove HTML markup function with the parentheses already in. Here is the input that doesn't work properly. Note the usage of a backslash in order to escape the single quote, which otherwise would be seen as a delimiter around that string. We can print this out to see whether it contains the right value. And you see it has the don't in here exactly as in our example. In order to address this issue, we need to record which quote character we actually had and which we need to check for again. For this, we need to change these lines in here. What we're going to do is we're going to use the quote variable to store the quote character. You see? Now quote is either false or it contains a double quote or a single quote, and this makes it implicitly true. Now this does only work when the quote variable is false yet, and this is how we start a quoted string. When we see that very quote again, we set quote to false, and this is what should now finally fix the problem in this HTML input, and we press run. And now the single quote and the double quote is properly handled, and what we get is just the text without the HTML markup.